History, past, present, and future book one is as relevant today as it was in 1995. Michael is no longer here to speak for himself, we hear so often. No, but his music and crafted art is. And he designated it to speak for him in past, present, and future. The music from this most personal album, the History Era itself, is Michael's message for the world in response to current events and personal attacks. He isn't there to say a word, so his art speaks for him. Genius. History, Past, Present, and Future Book 1 was released on June 20th, 1995. My basic concept for History 25 is a triple disc set. So, disc 1 would be History Begins, the Greatest Hits disc. Disc 2 would be the History album in the narrow sense, History Continues. And disc 3 with bonus material. I like to have the original, uncensored, They Don't Care About Us version on disc 2. My guess is that the effects over those two words and They Don't Care About Us were only added because Michael wanted to change the History intro we know as Great Gates of Kiev. So he changed both. But honestly, this was a stupid scam back in 1995. There is something called freedom of speech and also freedom of art. You without sin, cast the first stone. And by the way, this wasn't even anti-Semitic. We talk here about Michael Joseph Jackson. However, also I like us to think about having come together in the complete version, as well as thinking about You Are Not Alone with a later fade out. Let's get to disc 3, the bonus material. A selection from Blood on the Dance Floor, History in the Mix, plus originally unreleased and rare songs from the era, plus new mixes, remixes.
Tell me that you're doing wrong. Well, I shock it all alone.
The project History 25 is more reasonable when it stands for one era. Blood on the Dance Floor is a sub-era to the History era, circa 94 to 98. But two albums, with the best-selling multi-disc album and the best-selling remix album ever. Still, if this is no celebration worth.
Too bad, too bad.
Therefore, it makes sense when at least these five initial songs from Blood on the Dance Floor, History in the Mix are part of this project. The 19th remixes from this album are outdated and were not in Michael's original plan for this release anyway. He wanted an EP with five songs only. It makes sense to include Blood on the Dance Floor here because we can't expect a huge celebration in 2 years again. So the needs are well met by now. The track selection of Blood on the Dance Floor History in the Mix has been changed for the vinyl pressing. In my opinion, the individual remixes do not make up the essence of the 1997 album. But the chart success History Lesson remix, which was released as a single with the music video, has good reason to be listed though. It brings us back in time, so we should consider History Lesson Remix be part of the History 25 celebration, so its official music video could be uploaded to YouTube. Those five tracks, I want us to think about choosing the Ghost full promo version. And let's just consider featuring Blood on the Dance Floor, as I call it, Suzy plus Me Mix. This is the mix with the dance break and also the knife in the intro. The next part would be the originally unreleased and rare songs from the era. In comparison to the other albums and eras, maybe the History era does not have many strong unreleased songs, but any great tracks will join the tracklist. We need to know our material before building anything up. Now the exact tracklist depends solely on the final chosen tracks. The principle is plain and simple. Only greatness counts. But this is my rough draft. Already released songs from this era, such as On the Line, Much Too Soon, In the Back, and Why, have never been together in this form. I like to see here Much Too Soon in its original version, such as In the Back in its original History version. In the Back fits the overall themes of History, Past, Present, and Future Book 1, and has been released before, so it's reasonable this one makes the cut. If there is a chance to add unreleased vocals to Why featuring 3T, then this will make Why extended version. This song was originally intended to be on the album. Instead, he went with You Are Not Alone and gave the song to his nephews. Yes, this is an original Michael song. Why does Monday come but Tuesday? And in the end, I like to have some great new special mixes or remixes, however you like to call it. Those could be a Scream solo edit, close to the live version, including new vocals. A new They Don't Care About Us Olodum mix featuring the unreleased gospel choir. But I really like to have a Too Bad remix that is close to the Michael Jackson's Ghost version. And the one thing I'd be the most thrilled about would be a Smile remix.
You'll see the sun come shining through.
This one includes a few alternative vocals and is mixed again with new accents and altering the 19th pop beat to make it more classic. For History 25, I have very, very special plans for Smile. I will discuss this in detail in the next video. However, when I just said remix or mix, I really don't mean something as we have seen in the 90s and ever since, like with Bad 25 or for Escape. I mean remixes like they worked with artists and bands like The Beatles, The Carpenters with their early 90s remixes, or even Paul McCartney's reissue including Say Say Say. Other examples are of course all bad remixes that have been published on individual singles or elsewhere. However, the remixes for this project should be shorter for the CD and close to the original. This means only changes in the mixing of the song and only minor reproduction, if at all. I guess some of you would call it alternate version. The remix part for History 25 could also be called the better implemented History in the Mix. I think that this structure of the bonus material disc from the Blood on the Dance Floor songs, the original unreleased and rare songs, and finally the remixes guarantees best quality. Critical fans will not be disappointed, and music lovers generally can also enjoy it. While listening, you shouldn't take notice that this now is the good CD and these are all the bonus tracks that we were originally not supposed to listen to at all and therefore aren't so good, etc. This is a compromise to get the different camps and opinions together. So merging the sub-era and the main era makes sense at all levels. History 25 might be the best founded and most reasonable posthumous release, because of the stone engraved message, which obviously hasn't lost its profound meaning over the course of time. And it is our duty now to remind of this and to manifest it still stands the test of time. To hear his story, you should open book one. I think I got you now, my friend.
No sense pretending it's over.
Let's also talk about sound quality. Many of you are sick with the extreme loudness war we have in today's music industry. So let's just define what great sound quality means. The music should not be compressed as much as it is the sad standard today. There will be a compromise with the best sound experience for every speaker. Every new record, every new song, every new pressing should be listenable and enjoyable with big home speakers. Without today's extreme loudness war. I'm telling you to open your mind. That was my concept for a CD release, the triple disc set for History 25. I'd like to go into other aspects in later videos. If you want to check out the songs that I mentioned in this video, you can find the links in the description section. Please show me your interest by liking this video. If you want to know more about my History 25 concept regarding merchandise, regarding singles, music videos, online celebration, etc., please comment further suggestions and wishes of yours. Tell me your thoughts, your ideas for History 25, and we will go in detail with the next episode of my History 25 video series. And also share this video to get the message spread. Thank you. See you then. Don't you think it's time you